know, Danny Jacobs, Roman, let's make the unification fights for him at super bantamweight as well. Maurice Hooker, you know, let's talk about making him against Ramirez or other guys out there, WBSS. Jarrell Miller, let's make him against Dillian White, him against Anthony Johnson. So we've got those guys now and we can start to make that happen. And I'm telling you, all the guys that have come with us, they will never, ever regret this moment. They're going to make great money. They're going to box all the time. They don't have to ask when they're fighting. Only box once a year. They're going to be pushed by us. They're only going to spend millions and millions of dollars to push their brand. So congratulations to the ones that got on board.
Google Andrade, right? He was with Banner Promotion, yep. Wrote the body. What was the pitch from you to Tom? What was the difference?
Just because he knows me, he knows what we do. He knows how we promote our fighters. He wants to keep active. He wants to earn loads of money. It's a very simple formula. If you want to be promoted correctly, if you want a broadcast that's going to spend millions of dollars on you, if you want to stay active, if you want to earn more money than you can earn anywhere else, come with me. If you don't, no problem. Enjoy fighting once a year.
Has Jacob mentioned anything about serving up a champ? Knowing that you're a personal friend, he trained you guys the same gym. Is there some way that he didn't want to fight, he wanted another round, maybe?
Who, Jacobs? Jacobs wanted to do it. Jacobs was the one pushing for it. You know, he, at the end of the day, that fight's sensitive. They've got the same trainer. They know each other. But basically, Jacob says, I want to fight for the world title. And Derevchenko said, so do I. And we said, good luck, shake hands, it's on.
How does the Saunders fight with Demetrius Andre come about with like the whole situation?
You oh, win the purse. That kind of that's how it happens. That's
so
how it goes down.
So politics get in the way of that?
No, I mean, the only thing I say on Demetrius Andrade is the plan was to come back October 6th, December, get active, raise the profile again, then this WBO fight come along. But he doesn't want to turn his back on the WBO fight. So now we've got to go out and negotiate that. If there's a deal, great. If not, I'll win the purse, people do it on the zone.
Eddie, do you have any fear with Golovkin fighting Joshua? No,
yes.
It's well documented he failed the drug test.
No, because he's already signed up to random testing. Okay. We also have additional VADA testing that is already in place. So I don't fear that at all.
Why do you say...
But I do fear the fight.
Okay. So, could you just elaborate when you said that Golovkin fight is actually the toughest fight rather than VADA fight for Joshua?
Technically a tougher fight. Okay. It's not as dangerous because I don't think Povetkin is as hard a puncher as Wilder, one punch. But I think he's very well schooled. He's the Olympic gold medalist. He's a bit shorter and you know he comes in with these big hooks, which is sometimes a little bit tricky for a bigger man. So Wilder is a more dangerous fight, but I think technically the Povetkin fight might be harder.
How difficult dangerous? Finalizing that fight when you were also talking about...
We finalized that fight a long time ago. Like we were getting Wembley over the line, we were getting DAZN over the line for Joshua. So this fight's been finalised. Actually, when they gave us 24 hours notice, within that 24 hours, we notified the WBA together the terms have been agreed.
So what was the notice was just to know if the fight had been agreed?
Yeah, they said, we need to know from both sides the terms have been agreed and this is done. You agree terms and then you send them the contracts, which we followed all the rules of WBA. Oh, that was 3 weeks ago. This is bullshit. Like, no.
Eddie, what made it so easy?
Because his team are more sensible. I believe he wants the fight, so it's very straightforward. Listen, the Povetkin fight's not as big as the Wilder fight, so obviously when you get a fight between two champions, it's always harder to bring those terms together. So it's easier to put a fight on between a challenger and a champion than it is two champions. But you know, the Wilder fight is one that we feel must happen. And hopefully we get that for April 13th.
Is there pressure from the other sanctioned bodies to Josh Ray?
Oh yeah, yeah. I mean, yeah.
So rather large baby behind you.
Oh, you're lucky. I was there to control you. Do you know what I mean?
Listen, I didn't want to mess my money up just yet.
Yeah, exactly.
No, not yet. When we get in the ring.
Is that spectacle good for the brand? Were you expecting that to happen?
No, I was expecting. Listen, the thing
you
is,
didn't expect me to come. What you expect? Don't run
is,
away.
This is the truth. Anthony Joshua is a great role model, but he's also a kid who loves to fight. And he's from the street, as both are. So when they get in each other's face, it only goes down one way. But Joshua weren't going to walk off the stage and go, all right, and he weren't going to take a backward step. And actually, when they walked out to the corridor, Anthony went, come on, and he went, all right, and they were walking off to go and do it in the street. But I want to get this guy millions of dollars for that kind of stuff. You know, no freebies.
See, the street fight was, I would have had him in a chokehold and wait till he tap out. I wouldn't mess up his pretty face yet. So, you know, I'm screwed like a little pig.
He's around, he's doing interviews. Yep, he'll be here, don't worry, you'll get him.
Eddie, did you know...
He didn't come all this way just to go home.
Eddie, did you know any other details about that $50 million offer other than it was $50 million? $50 million?
No, the $50 billion offer came from Deontay Wilder. So it's a bit like Jarrell Miller sending me a text saying I'll give you $50 million. I love him, but I'd like to see the colour of the money. Nor Deontay Wilder. So listen, at the end of the day, that's said and done now. We've got to focus on the future. Right now, our plan is very straightforward. September 22nd, April 13th. The good news is that I've always felt like the Anthony Joshua Jarrell Miller fight was a big fight. But listen, maybe it hasn't had as much legs after today. It's got a lot more legs. He's got to take care of business on October 6th in Chicago. And then he's going to fight the winner of Manuel Char against Oquendo, the WBA regular. Or he can jump straight into the Joshua fight. There's going to be a lot of people calling for that fight now.
In September, do you start up from scratch? Do you have to sit down and negotiate?
No, they've got their offer. They've got the offer. Wilder, he either takes it or he doesn't take it. Very simple.
Hey, Eddie, why was Wembley Stadium not available to Deontay Wilder, but it's available?
It was available for Deontay Wilder.
You said in the interview when you did with IFL TV that it wasn't available.
No, I said the date wasn't available because Canelo against Golovkin got made.
We all know that Canelo Alvarez versus fights on the same 2 days.
Doesn't matter, there was no fight scheduled. The Golovkin fight wasn't made. They were talking about fighting Spike O'Sullivan. I'm more than happy to go up against Canelo against Spike O'Sullivan. When the Golovkin fight got made, September 15th, and all of September was completely out. So we moved it to end of October, early November. Mr. Finkel knew that. He knew the dates we were working on. Forget about, there was no date in the contract. It was documented. It was in every interview going when that fight was going to be. So
that's what I'm saying. The fight with Alexander Pettis is going to be September 27th.
Correct.
Like you said, Deontay Wilder versus Joshua is going to be available.
Yeah, because it's completely different money coming in from a US broadcaster and pay-per-view. You can't go to a US broadcaster a week after Canelo Golovkin and say, do you want to run a pay-per-view? Or DAZN, do you want to spend four times as much as you're spending on a Povetkin fight to get behind this fight when you've got a US market that's flooded with Canelo against Golovkin?
I mean,
you guys, not you particularly, but these people will try and trick me into saying things. I'll talk to you all day. I've got the answers to everything. It's all the truth and it's all logical. The fact is, you can't get the pay-per-view money, you can't get the massive rights fees going a week after Canelo Golovkin in a US market where that fight is much bigger at the moment than Wilder against Joshua in the UK. So that is why we had to move it to October, November.
I think the super fight for Demetrius Andre is him and Jamal Charlo. They've got the history.
Charlo, I like. Listen, I'm talking to Charlo, and Charlo's got to understand that this is where the money's going to be. And what's happening with a lot of these fighters at the moment is I will go to them and I will make them an offer, and people will match it and say, I'll do that. I'll box you three times a year. I'll pay you that money. My note to fighters is get it in writing. Because one thing I do, and this man, although he might not be my biggest fan, but I believe he'll say it. I've delivered everything that I've said so far.
No, except AJ.
Oh, AJ. I've never promised you, AJ.
Yes, he did. Get it, go back. He said, if I beat the French guy and you jump in the corner and you say, AJ, you get AJ. No.
I didn't say that.
The English muffin jumped to the plate and totally forgot about us.
Listen.
It's all right, though.
I've given you the fights. I've given you the money. I've kept my word.
No, I mean, other than that, yes, he has. Well, HBO and Eddie Hearn stepped up to the plate when Showtime did some, you know, some stuff I didn't like. And he's continued to constantly keep me moving and keep me active.
You've got to be active.
But like I said before, the main thing we want is become heavyweight champ. We want that title shot. And if Deontay didn't want it, I want it. You want to fought the small little leprechaun Russian.
Adrian Broner released the email from you guys with the offer.
It's all right. I signed the guy he was going to fight. I signed the guy that beat him in the last fight.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So Adrian Broner, if you're watching this, come and fight Jesse Vargas on DAZN. Give you more money than you made on the last fight.
Are you interested in Manny Pacquiao?
Yeah, absolutely. I don't know his situation with Top Rank, but if he is a free agent, we'll definitely be talking to Manny Pacquiao about fighting on DAZN.
Fighting Amir Khan, because Amir Khan seems to be angling
definitely,
away from
definitely
Kell
a potential
Brook.
Fight. I'd like to still make the Kell Brook Amir Khan fight.
Do you think it's going to happen though? It seems like Brook, Khan doesn't want it.
I hope it happens, but we'll see.
What separates this streaming service from something like, for boxing, from a boxing fan's perspective, this streaming service from something like ESPN Plus?
I think this is going to be, I think the content will be better. There you have a situation where there's a linear broadcaster, and they'll be mixing and matching the content, some on the app, some on the, on the platform, which is going to be part of the strategy. Here, this is going to be purely on the DAZN app. So all the content's there, all the fight cards, from 6 p.m. till midnight, all the chat shows, all the build-up. You've got the World Boxing Super Series, you've got our UK shows, you've got Bellator as well. It's $2.50 a week. You know, so our plan is just to flood you guys, to keep the content rolling, keep the news coming, to get everyone involved. You know, make it a platform for the fans. So
could you give us an idea? You know, we heard like great cards. Yeah. Could you give us like a...
Well, listen, let's talk about October 6th right now. So we've got Jesse Vargas, who's going to be headlining Chicago, will announce his opponent shortly. You've got Baturbia, the IBF world champion, going to be fighting Callum Johnson. You've got Katie Taylor, going to be defending her two belts against Cindy Serrano. You've got Jarrell Miller, going to be on that card as well. You've got, looks like, Demetrius Andrade is going to be on that card, maybe even against Billy Joe Saunders. That's six championship fights already, starting at 6 p.m. These cards go, we have to make sure that these cards are stacked from top to bottom. Because if we're coming on air at 6, it's not going to be, oh yeah, let's show this four-rounder. Like, these have got to be stacked right to boxing, where fight fans can sit down in their sofa, watch 5 hours or 6 hours of boxing and go, that was unbelievable. What great value. You know, you might have something on, in a day you might have the World Boxing Super Series. Then you've got us from Chicago. You know, then you've got like Bellator the night after. Then you've got, it's going to be peanuts.
Yeah. Eddie, so what did you think about Steven Espinoza tweeting out that Broner was getting paid more than that when, like,
well,
on the record,
so,
they have different
So
numbers.
In that case, he must be getting $1.5 million on the side somewhere, which for
is
me,
that something that's
I don't know. Listen, maybe,
that...
maybe I don't know enough about the sport. I didn't think that was the right way to do business. I didn't even know if that was legal, but it's not for me to say.
Now, one of the complaints among women's boxers is they say that when there's a women's fight on a card, they'll never put another.